The Corn Raid by James Lincoln Collier. Narrated by Charlie Thurston. Chapter 1. I was kneeling in the dirt, weeding around the tobacco seedlings. It was only April, but by 10 o'clock in the morning, the sun was already hot on my back, and the earth had that dry smell that it gets. It would have been easier to grub out the weeds with the hoe, but if I got careless with the hoe, I could knock over one of the seedlings, and Laden would whip me for it good. Laden liked whipping his servants. To be safe, I'd put the hoe down, and was weeding the seedlings by hand. Someday I'd be big, and would get away from Laden. I was 12 and pretty strong for my age, because of all those years of hard work I'd done, but I wasn't big enough yet. If I ran off, he'd catch me easy, and the governor would make me go back to him. But someday, when I was bigger, I would. It was all I ever thought about. Day and night I planned out how I was going to do it, and what I was going to do when I was free. It gave me hope. I was going along like that, thinking about not being a servant anymore, when I saw something move at the edge of the woods that grew along the bottom of the tobacco field. I stood up and looked over there, shielding my eyes with my hand. Beyond the line of trees was the James River. Nothing moved. There was no breeze. It might have been an animal that I saw. There was no shortage of squirrels and possums in those woods. Deer, too. They could move mighty quick through the woods and disappear on you in a second. I knelt down again. My knees had hardly hit the dirt when I saw another flash of movement. I looked up. An Indian boy was running off through the trees. I remembered that I had left the hoe over there somewhere. A shock went through me. I jumped up and began shouting, "Mr. Laden, Mr. Laden!" Then I was running after the Indian boy as fast as I could go across the field of tobacco seedlings. A hoe was a valuable thing in Virginia. If that Indian boy got away with ours, Laden would blow up like gunpowder and whip me until I could hardly walk. The Indian had got a good start on me. He was used to slipping and sliding through the woods. I was going to have a mighty hard time catching up with him, and I got that bad feeling where you're desperate for something to come out right, but you know it isn't going to. Maybe I'd have some luck. Maybe he'd trip and twist his ankle on a root or something. I raced across the fields and into the woods. I could see the Indian ahead of me, going for the river, just a flash here and there as he slipped around the trees. "Hey," I shouted, "drop that hoe." Then I shouted, "Mr. Laden, there's an Indian stole the hoe." The Indians loved our hoes. They loved our axes, shovels, knives, swords, anything made of metal. They didn't have any metal, only stone and wood tools, which were pretty good for what they were, but not up to metal ones. Why had I been so careless? Why hadn't I kept that blame hoe close to me? What the devil was I thinking about? I tried to come up with some excuse, like the hoe was lying right next to me and the Indian crept up behind me and grabbed it. Something. Anything. Laden would say he'd learn me about being careless with other people's property, and he'd whip me until my tail was swelled up and puffy when you touched it, and I wouldn't be able to sit down for a week. Ugh, I hated him when he whipped me. It didn't happen more than 2 or 3 times a year, but the awfulness of it stuck for a long time. I hit the woods. The Indian boy had turned and was running along the edge of the James River, where the trees came down to the bank. Suddenly I realized that he'd cornered himself. Ahead of him was a place where a creek ran down into the river. It was marshy there, a big patch of reeds. You couldn't swim through it, and it was hard to walk through, for the bottom was all mushy. If he went into the marsh, I'd be able to catch up with him easy. Then what would I do? Did he have a knife or a hatchet? I felt in my belt for my knife to make sure it hadn't fallen out of its scabbard while I was running. What was I going to do, attack him with my knife? Suppose he had a knife. Would we have a knife fight? I sure hope.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.